Hatchery works with third grade through fifth grade. Our ultimate goal is science, connecting science to the real world.
Does everyone know what's going to happen tomorrow?
Yeah, they're going to be taken away.
Yeah, how you feel about that?
Sad.
We're going to come out to the courtyard and we'll have two biologists come out here. They're going to take all the fish out of the trough and they're going to put them in a cooler. And then at that time we can celebrate what a great job we did raising those fish from eggs, and then they'll load them onto a truck. They're going to take them up to North Georgia and they'll stay there till they're big enough to be released. But then we're going to start again in the spring. We're going to start all over again. How many of you all would like to be involved in that project?
Okay. A couple of years ago when Dr. Mindy DeSalvo, who is my boss, was in Maine and observed a school raising salmon and said, well, why can't we do that here in the state of Georgia? She found a fish biologist who was able to design a mini hatchery for a school, and we met with business partners, we got other staff members on board, other teachers who were willing to pilot the program. We're going to divide in our groups, and we're going to start with the water quality in the water exchange group. And then we'll have a group working on camouflage, which we've been studying this week. Then we're going to have a group working with the newsletter, because we've got to put out our final newsletter to our school community to let them know about the release. All right, well, let's get going.
I like feeding the fish and taking care of them. Well, it's kind of really fun, but you have to be responsible.
My favorite thing about small fry would probably be watching the fish grow and, like, become different.
Who wants to take the DO?
Me.
I will.
Okay. All right, let us know when it beeps.
The readings that we take are the DO, which is the dissolved oxygen, and it should be between 8 and 10 so that the fish can breathe good.
The DO is 9.2.
The temperature has to be 60 degrees or below because the fish likes it cold. If it gets too hot, then the fish will die.
What's the temperature?
60 degrees.
Okay, you want to go ahead and record that?
Yeah.
We have to release the water from the trout, and that allows us to fill it back up with fresh, dechlorinated water. We use the water that comes out of the hatchery to water our plants because that's good nutrient water for living things like plants.
And this is going to be the final time that we feed our fish. Does anybody know why?
This project brings science to the forefront. It gives them a real-world application of what a scientist does, of what living things need to live in, to breathe, and incorporates all those math and observation skills that a scientist would use.
Okay, so we fed them. Let's go ahead and put a check mark by that, and let's go ahead and take the ammonia and see how we're doing with that. Now, why do we need to take ammonia?
Because if there's too much, the fish might die.
What's an acceptable ammonia level for our fish?
Zero.
What was it this morning?
Two.
That was very high, wasn't it?
Yeah.
That was after a whole day of feeding. Then we came in the next hour and we dropped it because why?
We change out the water.
Right, we change out the water. And that we add in fresh dechlorinated water that doesn't have any ammonia in it. So that helps drop it. And look how well we did today.
Before small fry, I didn't know a thing about raising a fish. I didn't know about how much chlorine in the water was healthy, how much ammonia in the water was healthy, what DO was. So you're talking to someone who knew absolutely nothing about raising a rainbow trout.
Maybe between 0.5 and 1?
Yeah.
Would you say 0.8 would be a good decimal?
Yes.
So having that hands-on experience, working with the students, learning along with the students, I mean, it was just little baby steps along the way. You've learned more and more.
So this is where they're going to be released. This is the pond. When they come to get them tomorrow, they're going to bring them up here and they're going to release them here.
The second activity we did today was on camouflage and animal adaptations. We are piloting that curriculum, and this was one of the lessons that we're going through with small fry.
All right, guys, over the past couple days, we've been looking at different websites, looking at animal adaptation and camouflage. Based on what you saw at Sawyer, what do you think it means to be camouflaged?
To become one with your environment.
Right, so you blend in with your surroundings. Well, now, today, since we've looked at lots of animals, we're gonna go ahead and look at the trout. Look at your picture. What is something that's on the trout that might help it blend in with its surroundings? What do you think, Tyler?
I think it can blend in with like the surface, near the surface, because there are different colored things on the surface. It might can blend near the edge.
Good job. Do you remember when we did the big trout that we hung outside? When we finished, what was something that we put on it? Nicola, what was something we put on it?
We put black dots on it.
We put dots on it. And do you think those dots help it blend in with
the
surrounding?
Because the water's very dark. And
the water's dark. And what do you think is at the bottom of the river? What do you think, Lewis?
Rocks.
Rocks. So maybe the spots help the trout blend in with the bottom of the river. So the spots are one thing, and the color is one thing. Look at the bottom of the fish. Ella?
It's like sandy colored, so that the bottom of the fish kind of matches the bottom of the stream or river.
Right, so it blends in. Look at the shape of the fish. Are all fish this very same shape?
No.
No. So what do you think about the shape? Nicola?
It kind of looks like a torpedo.
Good job. What were you going to say, Tyler, back there?
Because of its nose, the water goes around it, so it can move faster.
That's exactly right. So all these things that we've talked about are ways that the trout is adapting to its environment. So
communication with the small fry program, with the day school and the after school program, lends itself very easily.
And write another article for our final newsletter that's gonna go out.
Third activity that we did today was creating a newsletter. And also writing a script for our morning announcements to let our school community know about the Small Fry Club and what we do.
So how do you want to start?
Probably by saying that we helped clean up the courtyard so it looks better now.
So the environment looks better. Do you have a page in your journal? What's this a picture of right here?
It's the pond, and it had all this scum in it, and all the frogs couldn't really eat anything.
Right. It was yucky, wasn't it?
Yeah.
It was scummy, and then how does it look now?
It looks really pretty, and we released some of the dying trout in it so the frogs could actually have something to eat.
Something to eat? So do you think it's a healthier environment for the frogs now?
Yes.
Okay.
So tomorrow, it's going to be your turn to make the morning announcements for the Small Fry Club. Are you ready for that?
Yes.
All right. Can we hear it?
Yes.
Okay.
Good morning, Kingsley. This is the Small Fry Club. Today is the last day the fry are going to be here. We are sad that we have to say goodbye, but we know they have a long life ahead of them.
In Small Fry, we have been taking care of the fish. They are now in the developing stage of trout. Two men from the hatchery are going to be coming and taking them to the university, where they will be raised and then released into the Chattahoochee River.
Good job. We heard that you might have done something in your classroom because you were really upset and disappointed about the fry leaving.
I made a petition, and I had a lot of people sign it. It just said petition, and then it said to keep the trout a little longer.
And did your whole class sign it, including your teachers?
Yeah.
Do you know why that we've got to send the fish away at this time?
Because they're old enough, and they would die if they stay in that little
trout. Right, it's not enough room, is it? You are exactly right. Good job. Small fry to go is specifically for rainbow trout, but it doesn't necessarily have to be rainbow trout. If you're living in another part of the country, say Texas, where bass might be more indigenous to the area, or the Northwest, where salmon might be more indigenous, they certainly could do the same kind of program. All an after-school program would need to do is acquire a partnership with their state natural resources department and other business partners.